Hey, hey! So today's video is going to be a sexy beach curls look using my Bia Sassoon Magic Curl on the highest heat, and as you can see, it is a clampless tong, which means that if you have a glove, please use it because you will burn yourself most likely, because I tend to. I'm also using my Tresemme Heat Protectant Spray and a little crocodile clip type thing. Now I'm just going to section off my hair. However way you find is the easiest, but I just like to do it in smaller sections with the under layer first, just because, I don't know, it's just easier. And don't forget that with the smaller sections you get tighter curls, with bigger sections you get looser curls, so that's how big or how thick I would usually start off my first section. So it's pretty straightforward. You just want to wrap your hair around the tong, and I tend to have to push it up, my hair up, with my little glove thing, because the way I do it sometimes it falls down to the very tip of the tong. And anyway, that's how it looks. And yeah, so now I'm just gonna do it in this bit here. I'm gonna curl it away from my face though, as you can see, and you can hold the tong whichever way you feel is easiest. I do it vertical sometimes, and then later on you will see I do it horizontal as well. It is probably easiest horizontal because the hair doesn't slide down the barrel, but I don't know, I'm weird, I just change it up a little bit. Oh, and if you see me like dancing or singing, it's me trying to, well, I like to think I'm successfully rapping to the game, so just ignore that. But anyway, so basically this look is actually really, really easy as long as you have the right tools, which is of course this wand. Keep in mind that the further down you do it on the barrel, if that makes sense, the tighter the curl is, because the barrel is smaller in diameter. And I just realized that I turned the thing off altogether, which is a little bit embarrassing, but yeah, I'm just gonna go over that area just again. Anyway, as you can see, I'm not really happy with it, but it'll do. Now, I was actually getting ready for work when I was recording this, so I've worn it to work, I've worn it out to the beach, I've worn it clubbing, I've worn it everywhere, so it is really, really versatile. That's pretty obvious though, I guess. So now you can see that I'm curling it horizontally, and it is actually a lot easier. I tend to burn myself a little bit more when I do it this way, but I think you'll see me burn myself soon. Yeah, probably quite soon. And if you find that your curl isn't tight enough, you can always do what I'm doing and kind of push it up, because it'll still be warm, so it'll still make a bit of a difference. So now I'm up to the top part of my hair, and I'm just going to do the same, and I just sprayed heat protectant in my camera, so that was really intelligent, Lauren, but anyway. So this look is really, really easy. Anyone can do it, honestly. I'm going to burn myself soon, wait for it. There we go. Oh gosh, okay. Anyway, so if the curl isn't tight enough, you can just, wait, I think I just said that. Oh, God, I am losing it. Anyway, so I always find that when I do this look, I feel like Michael Jackson or like Sandy from Grease, which is really kind of lame, but I think it's like the blonde hair, the curly hair, the one glove, the black clothing, it's just a bit of a combo going on there. Please keep in mind that my hair is not naturally this colour, so it isn't as healthy as it used to be. So if you do have natural hair and it hasn't been dyed, I suggest spraying a little bit of hairspray in your hair before you curl it, because it's going to guarantee that the curl is going to be a little bit more defined and will probably hold for a little bit longer as well. So this is the finished look. On the left, it has not been brushed or combed through, or my fingers haven't gone through it, so it is quite like crispy. Not crispy, but it's just a lot more defined compared to the right side. So I'm just going to run my fingers through it just to loosen up the crispiness of it. I think I just like saying the word crispy. Anyway, and then I'm going to grab a comb and just lightly comb through it, just so it's going to make it look a little bit more natural. But that is totally up to you. And here is the finished look. So obviously it is kind of beachy. I don't know what to call it. I have no idea what to call it. But anyway, that's how it looks from behind. So nice and wavy. And in case I get any questions, I don't have extensions. I have grown my hair. I've taken the time to grow it. So it's all natural, baby. And yeah, just doing a little demo and a kiss for you.